Thank you. fellow citizens, we cannot escape history. That is what he said, that is what Abraham Lincoln said. Fellow citizens, we cannot escape history. We of this Congress and this administration will be remembered in spite of ourselves. No personal significance or insignificance can spare one or another of us.
Thank you. Thank you. Buffalo, and good Saturday afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Hans Stadium on the Midland, Michigan campus of Northwood University. It is our honor and pleasure to have you here today for our spring commencement of 2021, our commencement ceremony. We've done it. Great to have you. We invite you to stand at this time, if you are able, for our opening processional. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Please be seated. I'm Dr. Kristen Stehauer, Academic Vice President and Provost of Northwood University. It's my honor and privilege to call this 2021 commencement ceremony to order. It is also my pleasure to introduce to you our stage party, which includes trustees of Northwood University, Mr. Robert Jamerson. Dr. Graham Williams, who earlier this morning received the university's highest academic honor, the Doctor of Laws honoris causa. Dr. William Parlberg, Trustee Emeritus. Dr. Albert Zender, Chairman Emeritus of the Board of Trustees. Dr. Kent McDonald, President of Northwood University. Mr. Chip Reeves, Vice President for Finance and Administration. Dr. Lisa Fairbairn, Dean of the Richard DeVos Graduate School of Management. Dr. Patty Tim, Undergraduate Academic Dean. And representatives of the Northwood University faculty. Faculty members, could you please stand as we acknowledge your contributions to our students' success? At this time, I'd invite you all to stand, if you are able, for the national anthem performed by Colette Morris, one of today's graduates. Following the anthem, please remain standing for the invocation to be delivered by the Reverend David Serafolian of Christ Covenant Church, Orthodox Presbyterian Church in Midland. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the United States of America.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting, that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home.
Let me read a bit of scripture before we pray. From the book of Ecclesiastes, we read these words. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. And if I might improvise, there's a time to study and a time to graduate. So that's why we are here. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, this beautiful weather you've granted us for this occasion. When we think back to a year ago, we were in the midst of a shutdown related to the COVID-19 virus, and we didn't imagine how worse it would get when just a few days later, the flood came through here, flooding much of our community, and of course, this campus. We thank you for your providential care in the aftermath of all of this. We thank you for the way you've sustained the university and built it. Thank you for the leadership of President McDonald, the Board of Trustees, the executive leadership team, the many volunteers who labored to clean up and to rebuild the campus. We thank you for the many generous donors who've given financially and sacrificially to rebuild and to cause the school to prosper. We thank you for the sacrifices of the staff and the faculty who've worked untold extra hours and bent and flexed to make things happen. We thank you as well for the graduates this year who've had to balance many things, in-person learning with distance education, along with the coronavirus. And we thank you for the way you've sustained them. And we thank you for this occasion. We pray your blessing on this day as we mark the milestone in the lives of these graduates and of the university. We thank you for your blessings. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Serafolian, and thank you again, Colette Morris, for that wonderful rendition of the national anthem. Now, please be seated. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Kent McDonald, President of Northwood University.
Good afternoon. It's the first time I've gone to a graduation and had to put sunscreen on, so this is a good day. Just 24 hours ago, we were here doing a rehearsal, and the skies opened, and it was rainy and wet, and we just knew that this would turn into a beautiful day. So on behalf of the Board of Trustees, Jennifer Panning, our chair, and the faculty and staff, I just want to wish all of you a wonderful day and welcome, again, provide a warm Northwood welcome to all our guests here today. In the stands, we know that there are parents and friends, sisters and brothers and cousins and nieces who are here to celebrate with you today, graduates, and we extend a very warm welcome to them. And parents, thank you for letting us borrow these amazing people for just a short while. They're coming back to you after today. There's always a group of people that I like to pull out of an audience, though. I've been doing this for a number of years. And graduates, these were your first cheerleaders. They often stood in the background and supported you as you made your way through life. But they're always there for you. And not all of them are here today, but if there are any grandparents in the audience this afternoon, could I ask you, if you're able, just to stand up so we could recognize your role in today's celebration, and in particular these graduates, and if we could just recognize the grandparents here today. So let me just shine the light a little bit more brightly on the real folks who we're supposed to be celebrating, and that's the graduates, the class of 2021. There will be a day that you will come back to this campus and people will say, you were from the class of 2021. You were that class. And we just need to thank you for all that you've done this year to allow us to be open and celebrate here today. It brings me back to an event that I experienced with Mary Ellen not long ago. We happened to be in Florida. It was a Sunday, a beautiful day just like today. And we were sitting out on the sidewalk type bistro, just having a morning coffee. And the strangest thing occurred just before our own eyes. A fire truck came down the road, the lights weren't on, and it stopped just about 40 meters, 40 yards, there's my Canadian hint coming out, 40 yards down the road, and blocked the traffic, and then very carefully pulled itself in, backed into a very narrow laneway. We enjoyed the lunch that we were having at that time and didn't make much of it, but over a couple of minutes, we noticed cars starting to back up, and in particularly the pedestrian traffic was starting to back up. And so after 4 or 5 minutes, there were probably 70 or 80 people standing on the sidewalk. And that's when I noticed the firefighter was no longer in the cab, but rather on the ladder and in a ladder truck. And he was bringing himself up to the side of a building. That's when I started to pay a little bit more attention, because there was no smoke and there was no fire. And I got up from the chair and went over just to see what was happening. I joined the other 80 people. And I soon realized what he was doing was he noticed, or someone reported, the American flag was twisted around the flagpole and not flying properly. So he went about it, took him a couple of minutes, just very carefully cutting out the ropes and the things that had it entangled on the pole. And the strangest, most beautiful thing happened after that, that the individuals who were encumbered by not being able to walk on the sidewalk, when the firefighter gave that last pull and freed the flag from the pole, there was a round of applause. And it made me think deeply about what the flag meant for all of those individuals, but also for us here at Northwood. There's a lot in common with that event and your time here at Northwood University, in my view. Because I think the values that we exude and we try to build and bring out, that your faculty talk to you about in the classes, that we try to make and express ourselves on this campus, these fundamental values and principles that probably go back to the founders. Things like the fundamental importance of freedom, personal responsibility. This idea that we don't have to necessarily wait for someone in government to tell us what has to be done. That the Northwood idea tells us that we can actually take action. And we saw it 8 days from now. It will be the first anniversary of the flood. In fact, graduates, in 8 days, 1 year ago, you would all be underwater right now. That if you look carefully at that photo, this turf that looks like it was water abutting the edges of it was actually floating up to the top of the goalpost as far as it could float. And what did Northwood do? What did you do? What did the students, other students do, the faculty and the staff, members of the community, alumni? By the hundreds, they came back to this campus and said, we are going to be ready to be open in 100 days because that's what our students want. So that moment in Florida, watching people cheer and the freeing of the flag and carefully protecting it, taking it down, reminds me of the people who have served this country. It reminds me of a young man by the name of Andrew Wheeler, who couldn't be here today. Andrew was deployed today as one of your graduates. So early this morning, I called him. I was able to find his cell phone number and give him a ring. Wished that he would be here, but wished him all the well in the future serving his country. Andrew didn't pick up the phone. It went into his message. He was probably already in that line of work, had 2 or 3 hours under his belt by then. But I think of Andrew, I think the people that serve, and I think of you as graduates who will leave here today, going out to make a difference, ready to reflect all the things that we believe in. And the last part of the Northwood idea that I think is so unique is the idea of free enterprise. It is remarkable to me, as someone who actually studies other higher education institutions, that one-third of our graduates own or co-own their own companies. It is hardwired into the DNA of you as graduates that you have personal responsibility and you are the ones who control your future. So on behalf of the board, the incredibly dedicated faculty and staff who put you here and got you ready for this moment, I just want to wish you all the very best. I will look forward to seeing you up on stage. We'll take a photo. It will be described later. There's hand sanitizer up here to keep us all good. And you should be extremely proud. And the parents and the people who join us here today, you should be extremely proud of these individuals here today. So enjoy this beautiful, glorious day, and all the best to every single one of you. Thank you very much.
Please welcome Dr. Lisa Fairbairn, Dean of the Richard DeVos Graduate School of Management, for the conferring of our graduate degrees. Dean Fairbairn. Students,
We are here today to celebrate you, your hard work, and to recognize your significant achievement in earning your master's degree. Dr. Stehauer will be reading your names so that we may recognize you individually. Graduates, since we are outside and maintaining appropriate distancing, you may remove your mask as you cross the stage. We have set up the stage so you can maintain a 6-foot different distance for your photograph with Dr. McDonald, who has been fully vaccinated. And audience, this is a celebration. Please feel free to cheer for our graduates as they cross the stage. James William Dwinger. Chantel Dorothea Howard. Christy Lynn Gledhill. Audrey Mae Winchell. Richard Randolph Asherell III. Jacqueline N. Cheslick. Tiffany Renee Thurston. Sarah Ruth Parker. Jeannie Leanne LeMaster. Courtney Taylor Cater. Justin James Tober. Tara Jean Johnson. Tyler B. Vogt. Jamal R. Dozier. Thank you.
Paris Deshaun Liddell. Corey Calvin Collins. Rachel B. Elke. Taylor Nickel. Erica Hampton. Ricardo Alexander. Parker David James. Andrew James Kazmersky. Maggie Ann Stoles. Garrett Michael Russell. Jan Thomas Garolski. Jacob Michael Rogers. Stephen Earl Dunn. Taylor M. Hoffman. Casey Lynn Bishop. Deanna Marie Foxall. Tracy Marie Corbett. Emily Hannah Martin. Angela Shamas. Emily Lauren Pichette. Yeah. Austin P. Hobbs. David Russell Jarrett. Aaron James McCabe. Andre Mason. Jason Frank Smith. Caitlin Balco. Isabel Laura Hess. Bridget Kathleen Adams. Joy Latrice Pruitt. Mari Catherine Liska. Noah Miller. John Luke Perot. Haley Louise Hotstetler. Madison Lynn Cutler. Caitlin Ann McGill. Katie Joelle Icoangeli. Tyler Joseph Wellman. Joel Robert Hugo. Ethan Henry Zaglinichny. Justin Malcolm LaRue. Justin Travis Carter. Benjamin Thomas Budnick. Princess Grace Wells. Olivia Nicole Young. Jack Joseph Gertley. Benjamin Scott Haupt. Nathan Christopher Bauer. Corbin J. Cicchini. Demetrios Alexander Romain Scott.
Graduate students, it is now time to confer your degrees. Please stand if you are able. By the authority of the President of Northwood University, the consent of the Board of Trustees, and in accordance with the laws of the State of Michigan, I hereby confer upon you the degree for which you have fulfilled the requirements as set by the faculty of Northwood University. Among you, we are conferring the following degrees: Master of Business Administration, Master of Science in Organizational Leadership, and Master of Science in Finance. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, please recognize the DeVos Graduate School's Class of 2021. You may be seated. And now please welcome Dr. Patty Tim to the podium for the conferring of undergraduate degrees.
Students, the main reason we are here today is to recognize your significant achievements. This is the moment you have all been waiting for and have worked so hard to achieve. We will recognize you individually with Dr. Stayhauer announcing your names. And once again, graduates, since we are outside maintaining appropriate distancing, you may remove your mask as you cross the stage. We have set up the stage so you can maintain a 6-foot distance for your photograph with Dr. McDonald, who has been fully vaccinated. And once again, audience, feel free to celebrate our graduates as they cross the stage. Noah David Kenigschnecht, magna cum laude. Mackenzie Kepler, magna cum laude. Mary Gallagher, cum laude. Wesley Doxy, cum laude. Carly McCarthy, magna cum laude. Marissa Marlene Olmeda. Marley Ann Bromberg, magna cum laude. Nolan Thomas Worth. Jared Michael LaRue, summa cum laude. Dylan Joseph Hughes, magna cum laude, honors certificate. Austin Joseph Ashley, summa cum laude. Kelly Marie Kleba. Parker John Fairbairn, summa cum laude. Chelsea Marie Malams, magna cum laude. Casey Jordan Ruprecht. Elizaveta Velichko, magna cum laude. Miguel Angel Romero.
Vasilisa Mikhailova, summa cum laude. Anna Gancharova, summa cum laude. Ben Brandherm, summa cum laude. Yekaterina Vorobyova, magna cum laude. Brandon Robert Dowling. Logan Rosenbrock, magna cum laude. Abigail Machin, summa cum laude. Kayla Manley, summa cum laude. Kylie Fisher, summa cum laude. Andrea Renee Everett, summa cum laude, valedictorian. Cassidy Anna Embry, summa cum laude. Annalise Simone Hummel, magna cum laude, honors certificate. Grady Eager. Darius McCray. Stephen Adam Barker, magna cum laude. Hannah Boshina Novacek. Lauren K. Wisner, magna cum laude. Alex Marashai, summa cum laude. Hannah Marie Frawley, summa cum laude. Michaela Jo Philp, summa cum laude, salutatorian. Kyle Michael Netkowski, cum laude. Emerson Catherine Giese. Carissa Ray Wilcox, magna cum laude. Benjamin Allen Dusek. Noah William Weber, magna cum laude, honor certificate. Tristan Vincent Corzelius, magna cum laude, honors certificate. Lance Matthew Johnson, summa cum laude. Nathan Scott Powers, cum laude. Dylan Raymond Powers, summa cum laude. Hunter Anthony Barretts. Gunner Garrett Cole Jones, summa cum laude. Tyler James Bowling, cum laude. Brandon Austin Noonan. Matthew Michael Valancourt. Taylor Lindley Timoshak, cum laude. Colette Lee Morris, magna cum laude. Autumn Marie Schwabe, class of 2020. Woo! Jasmine A. West. Autumn Haley Tomasco, class of 2020. Emma Francis Scott. Bethany Lynn Matthews.
And we will just wait a moment to let all graduates get back to their seats. Students, it is now time to confer your degrees. Please stand if you are able. By the authority of the President of Northwood University, the consent of the Board of Trustees, and in accordance with the laws of the State of Michigan, I hereby confer upon you the degree for which you have fulfilled the requirements as set by the faculty of Northwood University. You are conferred the degree for which you have qualified with all the rights, responsibilities, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto. Ladies and gentlemen, please recognize the graduating class of 2021. To symbolize your graduation, it is time to move the tassel from the right side of your cap to the left, signifying the completion of this phase of your studies at Northwood University. Congratulations, graduates. You may be seated. As you received your diploma, you simultaneously joined the Northwood University Alumni Association. Please help me welcome to the podium Julie Ademchek, Executive Director of Alumni Relations.
Class of 2021. Today is the start of a new chapter in your Northwood story, a story that continues for life. Your role in the story has changed, though, from student to alumni, learner to supporter, receiver to giver. Think about the countless alumni who made your education here valuable and possible. The scholarships, buildings, halls, and events named after alumni. The prior graduates who gave you internships, hosted events, spoke in classes, mentored you, and the many more whose contributions went unseen. The faculty and staff who acted as your family away from home, helping you through the tough days and celebrating your successes. The spirit of generosity is strong in our community, and now you carry the torch to help keep that spirit alive. You are forever a part of the Northwood family. Being part of a family means we work together, using our own personal talents and strengths for the benefit of each other. You have honed strong values here, and we look forward to seeing them in action. Congratulations, and welcome to the Northwood Alumni Network.
As this commencement ceremony draws to a close, we would like to again recognize our faculty who have helped you on your Northwood University journey. At this morning, we recognize the recipient of the Samuel R. Murata Faculty Ethics Award selected by the graduating class and the Dale Haywood Faculty Excellence Award selected by a vote of faculty and students. Dr. Kristen Greiman, Associate Professor and Department Chair of our Management Program, is the recipient of both awards. Congratulations again, Dr. Greiman. In closing, we express our deep gratitude to all who joined us today to honor our graduates, both in person and via live streaming video, and all who made this ceremony possible. Reaching your educational goals is a significant milestone along a journey of lifelong learning and growth. This year has provided us with a multitude of challenges, and we are extra proud of you for persevering, and we wish you the very best of success as you use your Northwood education to create a positive impact in your world. Go make a difference. Now please stand for the benediction to be offered by the Reverend David Serafolian.
Please pray with me. Heavenly Father, as we depart this ceremony, we pray your blessing on these graduates. Guide their steps as the next chapter of their lives unfolds. Some will seek employment immediately. Others will go to graduate school. For others, their plans are still uncertain. Guide them all and take them in the path that they should go. Help them to bring with them not just what they've learned in the classroom or in textbooks, but the Northwood values and the Northwood idea. Send them forth as ambassadors of all that is good and honorable. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this brings our commencement ceremony to a close. Please allow the stage party to recess, and afterwards, please maintain social distancing as you leave the ceremony. Congratulations, graduates, and have a wonderful day. Thank you.